Welcome, Scott Allen. And we have an illustrious other judge, and she was a former Miss Massachusetts, and her name is Jillian Zuko, and she grew up here. And for the talent part of her Miss Massachusetts pageant, she sang a song. And guess what? You're going to hear the song that she sang for us. It's called That's Life. And if you're wondering who made that song famous, it was a guy by nicknamed Blue Eyes. Remember him? Okay, well, Jillian's got blue eyes, and she's got a beautiful voice, and she's going to start things off for us. So please welcome Jillian Zuko.
But I've been pretty active in the Wareham community. I have directed Wareham Middle School's music, choreographed Wareham Middle School's musical, and I am this year also. So I'm very happy to be here and support the Wareham Library. Yay! While Miss Massachusetts, it was a lot of scholarship money that I'm very, very grateful for. It was such just a stepping stone in my life. I'm actually an oncology nurse, so that's.
Wow! Yeah.
Jones. she has to deal with a lot of, you know, tourists and people who are very difficult sometimes, and that's it's a hard thing to do. You have to really balance, you know, she has a lot of social skills. And to show that off, I was going to, there's not going to be that much entertainment tonight because we had five acts and one of them isn't here, and so it's going to be short. So we're going to pad the show a little bit, if that's okay with you. Otherwise, we'd be out of here in about 20 minutes. So so I threw a script at Kat, and it's kind of a cold read here, but the background for this is, before I moved to Onset, I used to live on Mount Desert Island, and there are some really kind of fancy people who summer there, with last names like the Vanderbilts, the Pierponts, the Fairchilds, the Morgans, the Rockefellers, you get the idea? And they have their own little subculture there in Northeast Harbor, and there's some people whose last name on Soame Sound, and I'm not making this up, their last name is actually the Two Goods. Now, I'm not trying to make fun of them, but I'm going to borrow their last name and play the role of a fictitious Archibald Two Good III. And the place that he likes to dine in, is anybody familiar with Northeast Harbor and the Popplestone restaurant? So you know I'm not making this up. It's a really classy restaurant there, and that's where the elite like to dine. So we're going to let Kat be the receptionist at the Popplestone restaurant, and she's going to be dealing with me, and I'm going to play the part of, I'm going to dress the part first here, of Archibald Toogood III. And to be even about this, I'm going to turn my mic off because she's not going to be mic'd, and we're going to have to just belt it out here. So, now, Millicent, what time should we make that reservation for? 1:30, great. I'll call them up now, but I've forgotten the number. I'll call information. For Northeast Harbor, the Popplestone Restaurants, 276. Listen, can you connect me while you're at it, dear? Yeah, they know where to put us, Millicent. We're there every week. They should put a plaque on the table for us, for goodness sakes. Yeah.
No, they don't have a reservation. We'll just put them in the other room there. Assign a new waitress to them. Ding. Hello, this is the Popplestone Restaurant.
Yes, I'd like to make reservations for Sunday dinner.
Fine, sir. May I have your name, please?
Yes, that will be the Two Goods.
Fine. Mr. Good, two of you. Would you like to make that reservation for?
Well, we'll be coming at 1:30, but I'm afraid there's a little problem with my name.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, sir. About the time, there is a difficulty at 1:30. We're all filled up then as Two Good.
Yes, that's it. Two Good.
Good.
No, Two Good.
Fine.
Good.
Oh, yes, that's what I said. Now, what room would you like? The Popplestone room, or there is one table left in the Bay Room. Would you like that, sir?
Ah, yes, yes, we're too good for the Bay Room.
Well, it is a very nice room, sir, but if you prefer, we'll put you in the Popplestone room, so that will be Two Goods for the Popplestone room.
No, I said I wanted the Bay Room.
Oh, I'm sorry, I must have misunderstood you. I thought you said you were too good for the Bay Room.
Yes, we are.
So you want the Popplestone room?
No, I want the Bay Room.
I thought you said you were too good.
Look, I think there's still that little problem with my name.
And I said I was sorry to hear that. Look, let's back up a minute. Just tell me the first names of the people in your party.
Well, if you must know, my wife's name is Millicent. No, I'm not talking to you, dear. I'm still on the phone. And I am Archibald the Third.
Okay, then who is the second?
My father, of course, but I don't see what that's got to do with anything. He won't be joining us.
Look, Archie.
Yes?
You're the third?
Yes.
Then who is the second?
My father.
And you're the third?
Yes.
Good. There will be three goods for the Popplestone room.
No, listen, there are two good for the Bay Room.
Well, all right, fine. So we'll put you in the Popplestone room and we'll put your father in the Bay Room.
No, he won't be joining us.
I understand that, sir. That's why I thought I'd put him in the Bay
Room. No, we want the Bay Room.
Okay. We'll put your father in the Popplestone room.
No.
Look, Mr. Good, I'm sorry. Exactly how many people will be in your party?
There's still a problem with my name.
Can we forget about that for a minute? Just tell me, how many people will be in your party?
Two!
Two.
Good.
Good. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Oh, excuse me, Mr. Good. Could you hold the line for a moment? There's another call coming in.
What the deuce?
Hello?
She put me on hold.
Mr. Goodenough.
She's a nincompoop.
Jennifer, see you on Sunday.
I can't believe how incompetent this woman is. I'm talking to the manager about her. Get her fired. I hope she doesn't have like a job like an OBA director or something.
She'd be totally incompetent. I mean, listen. Now, Mr. Good.
Listen, young lady. I don't know to whom you think you are speaking, but I am too good to get waiting like that.
I understand you're too good, sir, but we have no tables left at 1:30. We're full then. Is too good?
Yes, that's it. My name is Too Good.
Please, Mr. Good, let's not start that crap again. No. A simple yes or no, please.
Fine.
It's too good.
Fine. If you insist on calling me Mr. Good, fine. For you, my name is Good. Mr. Good, just Good.
Oh, so we're not too good anymore.
Yes. I mean, no. I don't know what the hell I
Fine. Mean. Mr. Good, now what room would you like?
The bay room.
Oh, so we're not too good for the bay room anymore.
No. This is not going to work. Just forget everything. I'm sorry I called. My wife and I will not be coming to your restaurant. We'll just have to go somewhere else. Oh my God, we'll have to go to the Dockside or Bluff.
Well, I'm sorry. Then we'll scratch the two of you from our reservation
Fine.
Book.
Fine, good riddance.
But wait, what about your father?
What about my father?
Since you won't be dining in the Popplestone room, shall we put him in there?
No!
Okay, then we'll put him in the bay room.
No, he won't be coming at all!
Why not?
He's dead.
Since when?
He's been dead for 20 years.
And why did you want to bring him to the restaurant?
I didn't!
Then why did you bring him up in the first place?
I don't know. Millicent, quickly go into the bathroom and into the medicine chest and get out my vial, quickly. My pills.
Mr. Good? Mr. Good, are you there? Oh, we must have been cut off. That's too bad.
No, it's too good.
Very good.
How skilled she is, and that's why. Throw anything at that woman, and she'll handle it with aplomb. We've got. Oh, we've killed enough time that we've got our first act. Yes, is she ready to go? Yeah. We won't give her any chance to get nervous here. We've got, we're gonna start the show off with somebody who's been a pro for a really long time. And you're not gonna believe, she's only 14 years old, but I swear to God, she has been a professional musician for, how many years?
15.
Do the math. She was singing in her mom's womb, you know, but she couldn't play the fiddle in the womb because it would keep poking her. But yeah, you know, she did manage to, pick up that fiddle and has been making waves ever since. She's part of a group called the Celtic Kids, and they have been touring all out throughout the Cape for years. She's usually joined by her little brother, who's not here tonight, but she can hold the fort on her own, and she is a Wareham local, and she is schooled by the finest, her parents at home, and has had a variety of fiddle teachers, when I was asked, my daughter is 18 and she plays a whole bunch of instruments. She's wanted to pick up the fiddle, and I asked, who would be a good music teacher for my daughter? And someone said, Fern. Fern Panagini, please welcome her.
I've been asked to play to this, so
So I'm going to play an Irish, it's a jig. It's an Irish jig called The Kid on the Mountain, and that's just what we're gonna kick off with. I learned this tune from a girl who I was like taking a class with, and when I got home, I was listening to the tune and I was just messing around with it, and I thought, you know what, this tune, which is a reel, would be great as a jig, and you'll be able to tell the difference for those of you who are not expertise in this field, but. I thought it was a cool thing to do, and so I jammed it into a jig form. And so I'll play it for you now. It's called Tamlin. Woo! Thank you.
notice how relaxed she got as soon as she started playing that fiddle? Yeah. Amazing. It's like, that's what happens when you start playing at four. And that's why she earned her trip to Ireland. You practice that much and you can get all the way to Ireland or even Wareham's Got Talent. Are we luckier to have Fern Tamagini? Beautiful job. Thanks. Skip a generation or so, and we're going to hear from a woman who's retired. She's retired from running a daycare, and that wasn't the end of her professional career. She went from running a daycare to becoming a quality control person for the Defense Department. Interesting career trajectory there. She went from babies to bombs, and then back. And you know, and anyhow, she loves to sing, and we're gonna hit. We fortunately have a CD for her. Otherwise, she wouldn't have been able to do this. So get a cue. Three. Okay. We'll make sure it's up here. So, and just make sure the tech is with us before we start.
Is it okay if I say a couple of things first?
Yes. Say a few things yet, but then I didn't tell you who she's. This is Barbara Sterling. Please welcome her.
Thank you. I'm a transplant from north of Boston. I've been down here for about a year and a half now, and I love this community. I love this area. I really do. My husband passed away. And I'm married a very elderly gentleman who I met in junior high school, and he was the organist and choir director. And I went off to college and I learned how to sing, and I came back and he ended up accompanying me on various solos for churches and singing at retirement homes and such. And then we bumped into each other years later, and his wife had passed away, and his son had a little bit of a problem at first with my dating him, because his son is my age. But once he got on board, he really realized that we really cared for each other. And my husband, when he passed away, was 92 years old, and he was a wonderful gentleman. I loved him dearly. I just wanted to share with you, because this is supporting the Wareham Library, I just wanted to share with you how libraries have helped me personally. This particular branch, my particular branch of the family of the Woodbridge line, totally lost our heritage. And when I was out of work for a period of time, this is back before we had personal computers. There really was such a time. And I started researching my family history. And there was no ancestry, there was no DNA and all that. So I went from library to library and found the genealogical sections of libraries. And step by step, I went through every single town, not going there personally, but going through all the books in the genealogical libraries for every single town for the birth, marriage, and death records. And I traced back my ancestry, and this is a couple of things that I found. I found that I have an ancestor who was my second great-grandfather, who was a whaling captain, and he was out of New Bedford. And some of his artifacts and a couple of photos of him and his wife are stored at the New Bedford Whaling Museum. The line goes all the way back to the 1600s. My ancestor, John Woodbridge, came over in 1634. He was either the first or the second to be ordained in the New World. And from his line came a series of colonial ministers that started up churches in various towns throughout New England. And when you hear of different towns like Woodbridge, New Jersey, and Woodbridge, Virginia, and Woodbridge, California, they all came from that particular line. It's a wonderful heritage that I wouldn't have had if I didn't research in libraries. So I just have a real dear heart for libraries. I want to share this particular song with you. When I was a little girl, I had a very bad stammering problem, and I had a very difficult time getting out even one word. Singing was my way of learning how to communicate. And as I learned how to communicate, I learned how to relax my voice and was able to speak again. On my father's grave, my father died when I was just 10 years old, and on my father's grave, it has the phrase, "How great thou art." And "How great thou art" became one of my very all-time favorite hymns.
Thank you, Barbara. go back to a younger entrance here, and she's got a few years on Fern. She's got, I think, 4 years on her. We had to go outside of Wareham. It's not that Wareham doesn't have a lot of talent. It's just that a lot of our talent is in Carnegie Hall tonight or on tour and doing gigging around. But we did want to import this next person from all the way from Rochester. Because she's so good, and she goes to school at Old Rochester Regional, and she's a senior there.
We're reclaiming her
as a, she's an honorary Wareham resident tonight, and we embrace her. She is a very good piano player, but we don't have a piano here. She also plays guitar, and she's picked up the uke, and she taught herself how to play. She's also the choral officer of her school, so you know she knows how to whip her fellow classmates into line here. But she's going to do a song for us, made popular by the Lumineers. It's called "Sleep on the Floor." So please welcome Mariana Hebert, all the way from Nashville. And we have the sound with the support of Jason and John here from CTV. Give them a hand here. CTV, of course, you know it well.
Hi. So I grew up in the Acushnet area and moved to Rochester, so I've kind of been around the Wareham area for a lot of my life. My piano teacher, who taught me everything I know about music, I credit her with all of that, has lived in Wareham her entire life, Joyce Jacobson. she got me singing at an age where I didn't talk to people at all. I was labeled the mute girl in junior high because I had this extreme phobia of just like opening up and just talking to people in general, whether that was in math class or during lunch. I usually stayed alone and just wrote, and I fell in love with writing poetry, which is something that I kept to myself until 2 years ago when I started the poetry club at my school. And that's something that my piano teacher Joyce Jacobson, she told me I should embrace it and just to share that with people. So at concerts that we did in Fall River and Fairhaven, she would set aside 20 minutes for me to practice spoken poetry and introduce me to people that could help me get works published in newspapers, which I'm very excited to do this year. Wow. And thanks to her support with my writing, I think I'm more able to do stuff like this without being mute girl.
You're awesome.
Yes.
And I like songs like this. It's kind of an indie folk song because it kind of tells a story like poetry does, and it's just really easy to connect to. And there's a lot of emotion in songs like this that I appreciate. This is "Sleep on the Floor" by the Lumineers.
Back yourself a toothbrush deep. Back yourself a favorite blouse. Take a withdrawal slip. Take all of your savings out. If we don't leave this town, we might never make it out. I was not born to drown. Baby, come on. Forget what Father Brennan said. We were not born in sin. Leave a note on your bed. Let your mother know you're safe. And by the time she wakes, we'll have driven through the state. We'll have driven through the night. Baby, come on. If the sun don't shine on me today, and if the subway's flat and bridges break, will you lay yourself down and dig your grave, or will you rail against your dying day? And when we looked outside, couldn't even see the sky. How do you pay the rent? Is it your parents? Or is it hard work, dear? Holding the atmosphere. I don't wanna live like that. If the sun don't shine on me today, if the subway's flooded and the bridges break, Jesus Christ can't save me tonight. Put on your dress, yes, wear something nice. Decide on me, yes, yourself a toothbrush, dear. Pack yourself your favorite blouse. Take a withdrawal slip. Take all of your savings out. Cause if we don't leave this town, we might never make it out.
Barbara's story about having speech problems when she was younger, and Mute Girl here, and what art, music, and poetry did for these people.
Yeah.
Support the arts! Make us all be able to share our gifts with each other. Beautiful. I also want to show off your ukulele here, because the reason she bought this particular ukulele is because it has a figure there. I don't know if you can see that.
Oh, yes.
But it gives me an excuse to pad a little 3-minute song here in between. If I asked you what the first thing you thought of when I said the word chivalry, what would you say?
Knights.
Knights in shining armor. But those days are long gone. So where do we see good examples of chivalry nowadays? I contend that it's alive and well on the high seas. Because any good sea captain who's worth his salt knows that if his ship is in trouble, and it could go down, he's going to give an order to disembark the boat. And the reason that the word disembark comes from the fact that boats used to be called barks. So if you disembark, you get off. And who are the first people he orders off the boat? That is chivalry. Okay, and if a captain knows that all of his passengers and crew are gonna get off that boat before he even thinks about getting off himself, unless his name is Francesco Schettino. Yeah. You remember that fellow who ran his cruise ship around off the coast of Tuscany, and supposedly, while he's helping his passengers off the boat into his lifeboats, he accidentally fell into his lifeboat? Yeah, right. An interesting sidebar to that story is Winston Churchill had many occasions to cross the puddle, and thought it was odd that he always preferred the Italian cruise ships. And said, what's the deal with that? Because Her Majesty has the finest cruise lines in the world. You know, like, must be the food? What's the deal, Winston? He said, It's because the Italian captains don't believe all that crap about women and children first. You don't believe that story, look out the Snopes. And 80 years later, it's proven to be true. Anyhow, I contend that chivalry is not confined to the human species as is evidenced by the song celebrated on that ukulele here. It was written over 100 years ago by Wallace Irwin, and it's a scream-along song, so there's gonna be a part for you to give voice for this. The most chivalrous fish of the ocean, to ladies forbearing and mild, though his record be dark, is a man-eating shark. Leak neither woman nor child. He dines upon seamen and skippers, and tourists his hunger assuage, and a fresh cabin boy will inspire him with joy if he's past maturity age. Yes, I like a little gristle, a little more gristle on his teeth. A doctor, a lawyer, a preacher, he'll gobble one any fine day, but the ladies, God bless him, he'll only address them politely, then go on his way. I can tell you what a lady from Bream, who was tender and sweet and delicious to eat, fell into the bay with a... Here's your part.
Scream.
You have to do actually go. She floundered and flounced in the water, then signaled in vain for her bark. Bark.
Bark.
And she'd surely been drowned if she hadn't been found by a chivalrous man-eating shark. He bowed in a manner most polished, the soothing her impulses wild. Don't be frightened, he said, I've been properly bred. Read neither a woman nor a child. Then he proffered his fin and she took it. Such gallantry none can dispute, and the passengers cheered. Yay! The vessel neared, and a broadside was fired in salute.
Boom!
Then they soon stood alongside the vessel, and a life-saving dinghy was lowered, the pick of her crew and her relatives too, and the mate and the skipper aboard, and they hauled her up in a jiffy, and the shark stood at attention the while. Then he rose on his flipper and ate up the skipper and swam away with a smile. This proves that the prince of the ocean, to ladies forbearing and mild, though his record be dark, is the man-eating shark. Who'll eat neither
woman nor child.
That was a spontaneous thing, because she told me her favorite animal was a shark, so I thought I'd give that to you in return. So we've got two more people to hear from. And I first came across Bethany Lawson from an article in the Wareham Weekly. And there was this really beautiful article about the history of the duo that she formed with her husband, Jeff, who's here today. And they're usually a duo. And their original band name was called Angry Ginger.
Right, yeah.
And you can tell it had a little bit of an edge to it. And they morphed. And now they are Plastic Angels. So when I read the article, I read the Wareham Weekly, and I make the mistake of reading the comments section below.
Yeah.
And I have to say, there's some very, very mean-spirited, vile people who need to weigh in on anything that they don't approve of. And it hit the all-time bottom when I read this beautiful article, a beautiful picture of them, and somebody chose to say, gee, they look awful strung out. So, here is a Wareham, we should be proud of these people, they're doing great, they're making great albums, they're being received all over the place, they're touring, and we have to make fun of their look. And so, I thought, I was just so mad, I thought, and somebody actually called them out on the comments section, somebody actually stood up and said, hey, and it was kind of ironic to talk about this Bethany Lawson being strung out, because she did go through a period of, you know, some like piercing and medals and tattoos, but she's a minister's daughter, and her father has not disowned her, and she's going on to do wonderful things like coach gymnastics, and she's singing the church choir, and become an executive assistant at the Rockland Trust. Did she do good in her life? Yeah, a little strung, yeah, all right. But you haven't heard that? That's not the half of it. You haven't heard her sing yet. She sings like a plastic angel. No. She sings like that. Well, we'll see what she sounds like, because Jeff's going to stay in the audience tonight, but we're going to hear her sing a song made famous from the movie The Frozen. and that's why she's wearing a particular outfit. And we're going to hear Bethany Larson interpret Let It Go. So please give a warm welcome to Wilhelm Jones!
Interestingly enough, this is not what I was wearing in the picture that they made fun of. I didn't look this great. No. So, my husband heard about this Wareham's Got Talent to raise money for the Wareham Free Library, and he's like, oh, that's, you should totally do it. You should sing something crazy. So I thought, well, I love Disney, and my husband likes to make fun of me because of it. You know, we're in this cool rock and roll, like, alt-rock band, and I like to write sort of, you know, controversial lyrics, you know? And he goes, you know what? You should wear a tutu and sing Let It Go from Frozen. Well, he should learn never to dare me to do these kinds of things. So I'm going to do my best, but I grew up in Wareham my whole life. My dad's a minister at Tabernacle of Praise on Hathaway down the street. I grew up on Hathaway. I remember my mom taking me to the library, which at the time I think was still pretty new, and checking out the book Spiders in the Fruit Cellar. And I did check to see if you guys still have it. You don't. So I'm gonna have to find a copy because I'm pretty sure it was published in the 80s and it's ancient. But yeah, the Wareham Library is a cool spot for me to go to when I was a kid. And I think it's really important that, I know we all have Kindles and digital music and digital books, but I think it's really important to have things still written down. So this is a really cool thing to support the library.
Tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know. Well, now they know. Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door. I don't care what they're going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway. Money has some distance, makes everything seem small. And the fear that once controlled me can't get to me at all. It's time to see what I can do to test the limits and break through. No right, no wrong, no rules for me. I'm free. Let it go. Let it go, let it go. my soul is spiraling in frozen fractals all around. In one thought crystallizes like an icy blast. I'm never going back. The past is in the past. Let it go, and I'll rise like the break of dawn.
Motorcycle jacket and a tutu, man. That is classic.
She showed up for her audition with a pink tutu with a black leather jacket.
Wow. And she doesn't need any of that extras to, boy, she blew us out of the water there with that beautiful singing.
Right.
Thank you so much. And Wareham's own, all right. So we got one more person to hear from, and she's part of this crew that's working behind us. They've got Jason and John and Noah, and the outreach coordinator for WCTV is a woman by the name of Michaela Battino, and she studied marketing at Stonehill College. She interned at our local TV station for 5 years, and it paid off because now she's one of the staff. She's the outreach coordinator. And she's accompanied on a song today by her friend Josiah Beals. And we're gonna hear a song from her what a wonderful way to end this, the singing here, because it's a song called What a Wonderful World. Please welcome Michaela Battino.
Second to sit on up. But thank you, that was very nice of you to say. Thank you so much. So I do not have, well, it's not gonna be anything like the last one because that was amazing vocals right there. But we're going to be playing, you'll be right over there then. we chose What a Wonderful World, and specifically I wanted to sing this song because there's a lot happening in this world today. And I think we can all say it's a little crazy. And sometimes we don't take the time to see how wonderful this world is and how much beauty is still left in it. So I really want to take the time to sing a song that really did emphasize beauty and our everyday lives and in nature. And I think that it's sometimes hard to see it, but if you just take a step back and you listen to music that makes you feel that, it can reconnect you with the things that make you feel happy. So, chose What a Wonderful World by Louis Armstrong. I don't sing like Louis Armstrong, sorry. I wish I could, that'd be amazing, but I don't. So, Josiah and I are going to be playing What a Wonderful World, and if you know the lyrics, which most people do, you should sing along, because we want an interactive experience tonight. All right, take it away.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom.
You want to start over?
Take it from the top.
Take two.
Take two.
That's what's great about it.
Thank you. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Yeah. Thank you.
And Josiah! Okay, hey, what a wonderful night we've had! It's not quite over yet. We have to allow the judges to do some judging, and while they're doing that, I thought, you know, there's probably a lot of people here who would have liked to have been up here, but maybe you're just a little shy. So I'm gonna have you all sing along with this next one. It's not a scream along, it's a sing along, and a move along too. So in the middle of the song, you gotta stand up and move along with me. So how many people here wish they could be like really hot jazz singers? The hard part about it though is the scatting. You know, and you hear someone do it and you think, that's simple, they're just going blah, 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 but actually, scatting is a really hard thing to do. Well, so I'm gonna give you a scatting lesson tonight. I'm gonna a soundtrack here that you're gonna help me with, and it's gonna be a lot more fun if you swing along with me. Yeah. And copy me, and in the middle, you gotta stand up and do it. I got a silly little sing-along song. Got a lot of nonsense, we're short and long. I gotta make it up as I'm going along. Got a silly little sing-along, swing-along song. Baby, Bob, leave it up, Bob, and take your cue from the doobie-doo. Come on and see if you can swing it too, and I'm sure you can. I'm going to help you out with this. You're going to copy me, all right? I'm going to say, doobie, and you're going to say,
doobie.
Yeah. Doobie, doobie, doobie.
Doobie, doobie, doobie.
Squee-bop.
Squee-bop.
Squee-bop-a-ree-bop.
Squee-bop-a-ree-bop.
Bippity.
Bippity.
Boppity.
Boppity.
Bippity boppity bip. Bippity boppity bip. Bippity boppity squee bop
and doobie
doobie doobie. Bippity boppity squee bop and doobie doobie doobie. Oh, we love to swing and there's no way you can ever go wrong. Making up your own swing along song. Throwing just a bit of razzmatazz, then you'll have yourself a little thing called jazz. With your swing, you're gonna say, swing to the left, swing to the right. Baby, if you wanna, you can swing it all night. Swing it up high, swing down low. Once you got that rhythm, gotta let yourself go. Clap it and snap it. And stop it, and shake it. There's no way you can ever go wrong. Making up your own silly swing-along song. Throwing just a bit of razzmatazz. Daniel had herself a little thing called jazz. Okay, you're gonna put it all together. All right, we're gonna copy me. You're gonna stand up for this part. You're gonna move along with me. Come on, go. There. We know the words. We're pretty good. Ready? Doobie.
Doobie.
Doobie, doobie,
doobie. Doobie, doobie, doobie.
Squee-bop.
Squee-bop.
Squee-bop-a-ree-bop.
Squee-bop-a-ree-bop.
Bippity.
Bippity.
Boppity.
Boppity.
Bippity-boppity-bip.
Bippity-boppity-bip.
Bippity-boppity-squee-bop-a-doobie-doobie-doobie.
Bippity-boppity-squee-bop-a-doobie-doobie-doobie.
Oh, we love the swing, and there's no way you should ever go wrong. Making up your own silly sweet little song. Throwing just a little razzmatazz. Daniel had herself a little thing called and stomp it. And shake it. And clap it. All right, give yourself a big hand. All right. So we expect to see you on the stage here next year when we do this again. We're going to give the judges a time to do some judging here. And you got a first and a second? So, are there a lot of people behind the scenes to thank here? Priscilla Porter and all of her gang from the library. The Liz Riley, the president here. All the people who joined me. Hey, still going to be there. We need to wait. Yeah, the silent auction, yeah, I keep adding to it because, you know, we want the library is going to be recertified. Okay. All right. Hey. Again, thank you for coming. We're going to do this every year. This is the first year time we've tried the talent show versus a play. What'd you think? Was this amazing night? It's going to be kind of like a modest little thing, but boy, every one of these performers tonight was fantastic, you know, and they're all winners in my book and your book and everybody. But we had to, you know, part of the thing, we said there were going to be prizes in judging, so we have, I want to get in thanks Scott Allen, Jillian Zuko, Kat, the artist formerly known as Kat Jones, and Harry is going to take it over from here, so let's give them a hand, thanks.
Thank you very much. Let's just give a round of applause to Jackson, who is an excellent MC. Please get it. Thank you, Jackson. Wonderful, wonderful. He's absolutely correct. Every one of them was talented. It reminds me of the great justice who said they asked him, you know, what is pornography? And they say, you know, I really don't know what pornography is, but I know it when I see it. What is talent? You know, I don't know really what talent is, but I certainly saw it up here today for all five of them. We have gift cards for everybody. It's 100, 50, and 25, 1, 2, 3. And so, here we go, number 3. Wait a minute. Here we go. Mariana Herbert. Here we go, number 2, Fern Cavagalli, Cavagalli. Fern, is there a Fern in the house? Here she comes, all the way from the back. Wonderful. Big number, it's great. There you go, $50. You can't beat that. And now, number 1, the first person, Bethany Larson. There she is. Look at that dress. Wonderful. They've won $100. Oh, that's a royalty. believe that? Do you want to say anything before you leave?
Yes.
No. Okay. You did a great job.
Yes.
Oh, one last song. Yeah, you have to because you won. And everybody, and again, the other two, thank you so much. One more song. Come on.
Yes.
Yeah, come on. Come on, bring the house down. What do you got? What do you got, Clarice? What do you got? You got something. Come on. Who's this sketchy guy coming over here?
Come out to me!
Wait a minute, we're going to one more song, absolutely. What are you thinking? What would you like to, hear? Anybody?
Disney!
Another Disney? Another Disney. There we go, alright, we'll plug it in.
Farmer's Choice.
Are we ready? Alright, here we go. Bethany Lassen, one more time. Thank you.
Library, which is going to be recertified soon. Thanks to all of you people and the foundation people and the friends. You're great friends. Keep up our support. Spread the word. Give some more. Thanks for coming tonight.
Thank you.
And thank you.
Thank you, Jackson.